Now that you've created the app and trained a model to recognize comment spam, the next thing that you'll need to do is to integrate the model into your iOS or Android app. So let's take a look at this process. In iOS, you use CocoaPods to specify external files to use. And these are specified in a pod file, such as this one. And Google provide a pod for TensorFlow Lite called TensorFlow Lite Swift that you can use to bring in the TensorFlow Lite libraries. These will give you an interface that allows you to use models directly in your iOS apps. For Android, Android Studio uses the Gradle build system, and this similarly lets you use external libraries in your app. So for this app, we'll use a library provided by Google called the TensorFlow Lite Task Library for text classification, and you include it like this. The TensorFlow Lite Task Libraries not only integrate the TensorFlow Lite runtime, similar to CocoaPods on iOS, but they also give you a set of high-level libraries that can help you build apps for specific tasks. So in this case, the Text Task API will take on much of the heavy lifting of text processing for you. But what does that actually mean? Well, you build your models using TensorFlow, which, as its name suggests, deals with its data as tensors. Consider tensors to be a mathematical abstraction that can generally be used to fit any kind of data, including natural language, as we're doing here. So when you design a neural network, it takes data in and it gives you your answers or inferences about that data. For example, you might want to feed in a string like our comment spam here and then get a response telling us that, yep, that is indeed a spam. But neural networks don't deal in strings like this. You have to format your string as a tensor, and this has a lot of complicated steps. And of course, when it gives you the reply, well, that's a tensor too, which leads to some complexity for you to handle it. And the question is, as somebody who's a mobile developer and not a data scientist, and you're not using TensorFlow directly, but maybe writing in Kotlin or Swift, how do you do all of this conversion and parsing? Well, for Android developers, that's where the task library comes in, and it's actually pretty simple to use. You give the classifier your text, it's just a string like you used to, and the task API will do the tensor conversion under the hood. And it'll give you back a list of results. The category object is built into the task APIs, and this can give you details about the classification, such as the probability that the value is a spam or not. On iOS, it's a little more difficult because the task libraries are not yet available. So you do have to get a little bit more low level, writing values to memory that will act as tensors. We do have the full source code and guides to show you how to do this, so don't worry, you're not on your own. So now, let's take a look at our app. If I now type in a string like maybe make money selling stuff online and I put a link in there to visit a site, well, that really does look like a spam. And in the previous step, there was no filter, so this would just pass right through. But now when I click send, we can see that the model detected the message as spam with a really high probability, 99.999%. So of course we should reject it. In the next step of this learning path, you'll see how to integrate your model directly into your app so that you can get these results. You're going to do it on both Android and iOS, so let's get coding.